Hello, everyone. It is Thursday, May 10th, in the year of our Lord 2012. How are all you doing out there? I'm doing awesome. I think I guess somebody else is doing pretty awesome. I could be wrong. Hi.
Hi.
Hi, Delilah. Oh, our friend Justin Dimmitt, he wanted you, hi, Tails. He wanted to know, he wanted to tell you, that was the favorite color pink. There was something else that he said, and I forgot what it was. Oops. Well, our friend Justin Dimmitt, I'd have to look at your comment again, because you said something else. What was your other question of the day yesterday, Delilah? Hmm. Or the day before?
Who was my character kissing, I think?
I think you got that one. Ah, it was something about one of your characters. That's right.
Tails or Knuckles?
Something like that. One of them crazy characters. All right, folks, I got to make this one fast today. We'll try to. Sam Adams, Coastal Wheat.
Because it takes my dad's laptop about a few minutes to upload a video. This video's already been a minute long.
Yep, Sam Adams, Coastal Wheat. Wheat ale brewed with lemon peel from Boston, Massachusetts. Massachusetts, great state, greatest state in the nation. Without Massachusetts.
Hey,
go ahead.
Without Massachusetts, the states wouldn't even exist.
That's right. Exactly.
Oh, and it's kind of, it, foam was coming out of the top.
Mm-hmm. Alrighty. Cheers and beers to all of you. Alright.
Wait.
What?
This picture, I decided to be a little lazy.
Chicago Gold. Number 123. 2009.
I decided to be lazy today and...
Speak up.
I decided to be lazy today and I used a backup picture instead of one of my Sonic characters.
Yep. Delilah...
I drew this picture back in kindergarten.
Way back in kindergarten she drew that. She's had skills since day one. What is that, Delilah?
It's a picture of a dog with a bunch of... And this is when I discovered Sonic. I drew more than 7 Chaos Emeralds.
Oh, wow. So you like Chaos Emeralds way back in kindergarten, 4 years ago.
Mm-hmm.
Wow. She was only 5, 6 years old back then.
Actually, five or four years ago.
Yep, exactly. Alrighty, folks. Birthday shout-out time. My man, Bruce Starks, happy birthday to you. Worked with you in jolly old England, hung out with you in Bible camp last year. You know, we had the shake, boom, boom, you know.
Hey, and I named her Brownie.
Hi, Brownie. Bye, Brownie. So, happy birthday to you, brother. Hope it's been an awesome day for you. I know you're still hanging out living in jolly old England. That's right. Where the men are men and the sheep definitely run scared.
That was the Bulls.
No, that's Texas.
Oh.
Sheep. England has a lot of sheep. Okay? England's like one of the sheep... Well, I should say the United Kingdom is one of the sheep capitals of the world. Definitely Wales. There's a lot of sheep in Wales. Anyway...
Look, Tails has beer again.
These next two on the list...
Tails is drinking beer out of a bottle.
Wow, Tails is drinking beer out of a bottle. Cool beans. Next two on the list, my man Dave Sherman and Jess Fisset. I think it's Fisset, F-I-S-E-T. Now, I think I got your last name right last time that I had given you a shout out, but Dave, shout out to you.
When I smelled the...
I want to say Mafia Wars player, if I remember correctly. What? Speak.
When I smelled him... The water that comes out of the edge of the beer, then it smelled, but it wasn't where Daddy held it. It smelled like rotten eggs.
Really?
Yeah. But
you think my beer smells like rotten eggs?
No, from the outside.
Oh, the outside smells like rotten eggs? Hmm. Interesting.
And it wasn't where you held it.
Well, that's good to know. Well, it tastes great, so. Yeah, Dave, honestly,
every beer tastes great to you.
That's right. Hey, Dave, I haven't heard from you in a while. I'd love to hear from you. I hope you've had an awesome birthday.
He needs a bath. I accidentally got a little beer on his
Uh-oh, chin. Give him a bath.
Yeah, he got some beer on his chin.
And Jess, now see, Jess is a celebrity. She was in, drawing a blank. Ah, damn it. I'm having a rough day today. I don't know what it is. Daddy, Still We Believe, the Boston Red Sox Daddy, movie from 2003. What?
Uh-oh.
What?
Patches food.
Just now?
A few minutes.
Kick the crap out of him. Dog just pooped in the house. Again. Jack Russells. They don't learn. They're dumb. Do not get a Jack Russell. All they do is poop and pee in the house to mark their territory. They're lovable dogs. But, yeah, he doesn't get it. He doesn't care. He poops when he wants, pees when he wants. No matter what, he knows he's potty trained. He doesn't care. He's still trying to mark his territory. And on top of that, he eats poop. It's a sick dog. I wouldn't let him lick my enemy's face, let alone mine. Anyway, Dave, Jess, happy birthday to you. You're both the same age today. I guess you've been the same age every day, right? Yeah, you got it. So, have a wicked awesome day. Party hard and enjoy. And I'll drink to that as well. Cheers! Next on the list, my friend from back home, Megan Gillis, who I've known for over 30 years, known her since kindergarten. No, you're doing well. Always love hearing from you. Posted up some fantastic pictures last night, by the way. Thank you very much for that. Talk about reminiscing. Boy, awesome stuff. Megan's been posting a lot of old school pictures recently. If you look on my Facebook, you'll notice some pictures from me from youth soccer back in 1982. Before I started getting the cool dude, the flat top, you know. The babe magnet, if you will. And I say that because dating prior to senior year of high school was almost non-existent. But like a fine wine, I've gotten better with age. Hi, Sonic and Amy. Remember they got married yesterday?
Yeah.
That's right. All right, Megan. Happy birthday to you. Hope you've had a great day. Next on the list, milestone birthday. Squeeze me. My man, Mike Broder. Graduated a year before me. That's right. The big 30. 40 is the new 30. And Mike, I hope you've had an awesome day. I hope you're going to party hard and enjoy tonight, because you certainly deserve it, my man. So, I hope you're celebrating well. You certainly earned it. Make sure people are buying you beer. You're a good guy. I don't care what anybody says about you. Oh, thank you, Delilah. Thanks, Amy. Next on the list, my man Rod Stewart. Nah, this guy is not, this is not the fruity pop singer Rod Stewart I'm talking about. This is my man, Roderick Stewart. Awesome guy. Great guy. Way cool. Work with him here in Yeehaw, Texas. And, Rod, I hope you've had an awesome day. I was hoping to see you at work today, but I didn't.
Hey.
Yes, daughter?
These flowers are balloons.
Oh, wow. Flying balloons. Flying flowers. Interesting. So, Rod, hope you've had a wicked awesome day. Party hard and enjoy. Would have loved to tell you happy birthday in person, but I'll do it over the show. That's right. Now, additional shout-outs. And there's a reason for this. See, I'm going to unleash the license plates of the day now. And we're going back to my year of birth, 1973. The greatest year ever. And the greatest slogan ever on any license plate, live free or die. New Hampshire, 1973. Now, I need my New Hampshire friends that I'm about to give shout-outs to. I need to know what that LT means, if it does mean anything. Or maybe it was just letters with numbers. LT-727, match set, 1973 license plates. Green on white. White plates, green letters and numbers. And you can tell this is the front plate, bug splatter, all that good stuff. And this is the rear plate, and it barely looks like it was used. You can see the bottom bolt holes were used, but this plate's in really good shape. So, Matt set of 73 New Hampshire plates. Yeah. Awesome stuff. Wow, they're all flying now. They're flying high. Phenomenal.
The tail's upside down.
Oh, no. Bye-bye, Tails.
I think I'm going to barf.
Ralph. All right, so these next four friends of mine are all very good friends. Speak.
Tails changed his name.
To what?
Ralph.
Oh, Tails is Ralph. Yo, Ralphie! There he goes. He's drunk again. Schmuck. Matt and Kendra, goodness. Always talking to you two. Love you guys as family. You're phenomenal. And had to unleash the New Hampshire license plates for you. And I just want you to know it's always a pleasure chatting with you. Definitely keep in touch. Hope you enjoy the show. Enjoy that hot tub you got recently. I know you have. Yeah, I would be too. But I will be in Massachusetts from June 13th tonight to June 19th. I'm taking a show on the road with me, going back home to visit the family, you know. So Matt and Kendra, love to see you guys. Bring the boys with you. We'll have to get together.
Yeah!
And party like it's 1969 minus the acid. All right, woo! Next on the list, also from New Hampshire, my man, Steve Peterson. Awesome, awesome guy. Worked with him in Jolly Old England. Worked with Matt and Kendra in Jolly Old England. Great friend. And he's living large in South Carolina, right? I think. Or did you move to North Carolina? I don't know. North Carolina, South Carolina, same thing almost. That's right. That's the way I look at it. I mean, if you're south of Philly, western New York, you're a farmer. That's just the way it is. Sorry. Couldn't help it. That's an old Andrew Dice Clay saying. But, that stinks. So, Steve, Matt, Kendra, and also my man, Busboy Josh. I'm not going to bother pronouncing your last name. I screwed it up last time, so you got to tell me how it is again. Josh, a.k.a. Busboy. That's what I always call you.
I believe I can
Ralph? Oh, jeez. I know Josh is another New Hampshire guy. Great guy. Him, Steve, and I all had worked the same type of job. And, see, Matt, Kendra, Steve, and I, and Josh, all share, along with Delilah, we share the same hardcore love for the Red Sox, Patriots, Celtics, and Bruins, okay? Now, I'm going to tell you right now, the Red Sox are disgusting me.
The buried couple.
That's right. That's why if I seem a little angrier today, it's because the stupid Red Sox are the dead Sox because they lost two out of three to the Royals. It's like losing to a minor league team. Okay? Before that, they got swept by the Orioles, lost all three games. Before that, they lost two out of three to Mommy's Oakland A's. The Red Sox are 2-7 in their last nine games. And Josh Beckett is hurt, yet he was golfing. Clubhouse cancer? I'm thinking so. I think about time to disassemble Johnny Red Sox and rebuild. That's what I'm thinking.
It's storming outside!
Yes, it is. Lots of water out there today. Good day for a shower.
And in the parking lot, when my mom was leaving work, the water was up to her ankle.
That's right.
And the water would have been up to my knees.
Hard Rock Cafe, Angeles City, Philippines. Hard Rock Cafe, Guam, USA.
The water would have been up to my knees, probably.
Probably, because you're itty bitty. Note, still always representing my Red Sox through thick and thin. That's right.
Even though you call them the Dead Sox.
Well, they're acting like the Dead Sox. Call them as they are. And it's disgusting. I'm sickened. They need to do something. They need to do something fast because it's depressing. You know?
I love my
Red Sox through thick and thin and always have, always will. But I can get mad at them too. And Jess, I know you're upset with them too. I've seen your comments. She is like one of the most wicked hardcore Red Sox fans I've ever seen. I mean, famous enough to be in a movie. That's right.
Yay!
See, Delilah loves the Red Sox too, so. We love our Red Sox.
Now Knuckles is drinking beer.
Good job, Knuckles. All right, so we've knocked out the shout-outs, the license plate of the day. How about the song of the day? Going all the way back to Wednesday, December 5th, 1928. The late, great Blind Willie Johnson. And he's got his wife in the background vocals, Angelique Johnson. This song is called I'm Gonna Run to the City of Refuge. The greatest bluesman that never played blues. Listen to that voice.
I'm
listen to her voice. Good duet.
That feels so good.
Goody. I got things to do again tonight. Gonna be wicked busy, so that's why I gotta get the show done fast. Hopefully it uploads in time. Uh oh, what happened?
I dropped him.
Nana dropped him like a bad habit. Good job, Nana. Oh, Amy dropped him. Way to go. I see that. Doesn't affect me much. I've built up the tolerance. Beer a day keeps the doctor away. Remember that. Yep. Oh, random fact of the day. Good call, Delilah. What is the random fact of the day?
Never end up like tails
or knuckles. Never end up. It's really rare to end up like tails. That's true. It's not that strong. In fact, my salmon was close to wheat. I don't even know what the percentage is on it. I thought it was like 5.6, but it doesn't say. Now, folks, random fact of the day. Sam Adams, the Boston Beer Company, was started in 1984. Jim Cook is the brewmaster. Cook, K-O-C-H. Excuse me. Oh, wow. Careful. So, yes, Boston Beer Company, Boston, Massachusetts. And 1984 was started. And that really drove the microbrew, aka craft brewing tradition, wild. It did. Oh my. Careful. This song is almost over. So is this show, folks. Hope you all enjoyed the song, because I certainly did.
Did you hear what Amy said?
Nope.
Knuckles really needs to lose weight.
Oh, is Knuckles becoming a fat fool?
Actually, he's becoming a heavy one.
A heavy fool. A heavy one. Okay. No. No, we gotta go. Folks, it's time to make like a fetus and head out. So everybody take care, have a wicked awesome night and day.
Peace be
the
journey.
Peace be the journey. Don't do anything we wouldn't do.
Don't drink and drive by silly drink, going on kill someone or yourself, and drinking and driving is done with them being the Yankee fan with someone about is rooting for Eli Manning and many women. And don't drink and drive, especially when there's a kid in the car.
That's right. You listen to Delilah. She are smart.
Or you will end up like a first grader, an 8-year-old named Jarrett.
Oh.
And he was in a wheelchair! What do you expect?
Sad to hear that. Wow, the things you learn.
Oh, and here's another random fact of the day by me, Amy Rose. Don't end up like me, carrying Knuckles around.
Okay.
He's heavy.
Alright, gotta go. Bye-bye!
Bye!
Bye!